Philippine shares outperformed Asian peers on Thursday, seemingly shrugging off concerns over the U.S. yield curve further inverting, taken as an indicator of recession and trade war rhetoric. The index gained 0.5% to close at 78.92. Although overseas funds continued to net sell the market. They've been net selling the local bourse for 15 sessions this month alone.
Equities has really been hurt by the recent escalation of trade war concerns in the U.S. and China. In fact, major U.S. indices were actually down by more than 3% this month alone. Same story on our local front. However, we think that moving forward, the market is now positioning for the second half figures. We think that the market will recover, and we think that foreign funds may come back in. We're still firm on our year-end target of 8,400 based on valuations at 18 times PE.
For AAA equities, second and third liners are still the way to go, but clarifies the window of opportunity may soon be closing.
This has been a trader's dream. I mean, you have all these second liners and third liners that have gone ceiling plays every day for the last, I think, 10 trading days. And it all began with that Kepwealth IPO. My advice to investors is to be very careful. A lot of companies out there, it's pretty hard to, we don't want investors buying companies and getting left holding the bag. Blue chips are sort of inactive. I mean, after all of the losses in property and companies like Jollibee, I mean, investors are looking for something to trade. And it's been the second liners and the speculatives. Maybe coming to an end. We're seeing too much volatility.
Some of the big movers in the past days, like Anglo Holdings, Nalcorp, and Kepwealth Property, retreated for the day. In corporate stories, the construction arm of the Yuchenko Group, EEI, confirms it is participating in the bidding for the Malolos-Clark Railway, or the PNR Clark Phase 2. 11 groups are reportedly joining the bidding for 3 contract packages, including Megawide and 9 other foreign firms from Spain, Korea, Thailand, Indonesia, and Japan. The Malolos-Clark Railway, a segment of the North-South Commuter Project, is a 778 billion peso and 53-kilometer line project to be co-financed by ADB and JICA. Operations will begin by 2022. The Philippine Stock Exchange says it's going to lower its broker ownership to 20% to meet the limits set by the Securities Regulation Code by buying back shares and issuing 3.5 million preferred shares. This should help dilute brokers' ownership, last reported to be at 26%. This was one of the requirements of the SEC from the PSE during its bid to buy the Philippine Dealing System Holdings. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.